Now playing Dead by Daylight.
Like, I always play a couple of rounds when I first get a killer with their base, like, augments. I mean, base perks. But at times, I'm like, they can only go so far. And I, like, a lot of times, I do question, is the perk more for the killer or for the other killers to make builds around it? I mean, it only could go so far. And I wonder, like, I might have to look it up later. I'm really curious what the people's thoughts are on that. If, like, perks should be made more for the killer or more for everyone else. Like, it should be killer first, then everyone else. I mean, it's better than them just adding the perks on there and then being put on the roulette wheel of randomness when every time a new killer comes out. But I'm interested to see what the next killer is going to be. It might just be another brute force killer, to be honest. Like, Blight's one of those ones where I'm like, it's more of a dash. Like, if you put him in the archetypes, it'll be like the fast character, the I have not been here in forever. Oh, it's like the fast character, the medium, and then the heavy. I've not been here in a hot minute. This one doesn't where it's a 50-50 margin. Why did that go off randomly? All right, someone's downstairs. I saw a light scratch mark over there. Really? She wasn't looking in front of her. I don't think she might even know this map's layout that well either. She went. Oh, there's another. She got rid of both of them. See, getting rid of pallets early really saves you some time in the long run. Like, you can't guarantee you'll come this route again, but it's better than nothing. Oh, she's getting rid of so many of these. And I'm making her run the other direction, because she got rid of almost every single one that's around here. And she's jittery, so that doesn't help either. She got rid of so many pallets during that. That's amazing. Like, this might not be a solid game in the end of things, but like that right there, you only get those once in a lifetime. By that, I mean, like, you rarely get the opportunity to just watch someone just down that many pallets in one go. Hopefully someone does rescue her. Hey, buddy. That was weird. Did he mean to do that? Wow. No one's gonna go for the save either. Oh, never mind. Someone was going for the save. Okay, this is interesting. Why is someone messing up so many times up there? I mean, I really gotta stop kicking generators. It's a bad habit. Usually, most players would go for the grab. I don't know, it's really weird. Like, one of the things about this game's matchmaking is it's a 50-50 margin. Where, like, I remember I went over it during the, your video deal, but, like, there are moments where you feel like the matchmaking works, and then moments where you question, how do they know that I'm already going over? Hey! How's it going, buddy? Which direction would you like to go today? Yeah, that even got me. That's a... That collision. It is rough. This is where Thanophobia would be great right now. Oh no, we're going right back. Can't... No point in fixing what's not broken. I might have to kick that generator now. Everyone wants to really hit that generator. Like, they are really going at this one. Now then, while she's dealing with her dilemma, the one thing I like about this map is one of the few maps where I actually feel like the jigsaw boxes are really spaced out solidly. And they went this direction. Okay, now I'm gonna leave him. I'm not leaving him just so that someone can pick him up. I'm leaving him because I grabbed him already. I was trying to go for the other person. I thought they would be over there. But she got her trap off, so that means she's either going this direction or... And they got the totem as well, so... Once again, hex totems. You love to hate them and hate to love them. Smart bait. Wait, is this the same area where that one chick dropped almost every single pallet in the area? That was a 360 twirl that I kind of just put a gamble on. The other guy is still down. They have not grabbed him. I don't want to leave him to die like that, though. That kind of... I realize that is a very crappy way to do things. There we go. Now I can hit him again without feeling no remorse. See, I can do this without feeling any remorse. Oh wait, no, this is not the other person, this is someone different. Oops. I do wish they had a meter so I could keep track of how many times I've downed people, because it gets really difficult to... Oh, she's on the third one. Difficult to tell after a certain point. Definitely one of the person that doesn't have... I'm glad I put a trap on her. Wow, these headphones are very effective. Was this the same one I downed before? I can't tell. I'm fine with leaving this one. That one is in a decent enough spot to where I don't feel like it will mess me up in the end of things. She's gonna take the long way around, isn't she? No. I forgot that one was even here. He's down there. Oh, that one sounds like it's broken, and he sounds like he's really aiming to try to get that off. All right, let's go downstairs. Let's get a change of pace. It was too light up there. Hey, buddy. It seemed like he got his trap off, so let's put another one on. I think that's my favorite thing about this. It's just like, hey, I got my trap off. Great, I can finally continue. Oh, crap, of course. Alright, now everyone's free game for open season. Up top. It seems like most of the generators now are going to be up top. Still one person I haven't seen in a hot minute. And I did it by instinct again. Did not mean to kick that. Oh, why did you do that? That was a series of unfortunate events. I should be able to make it to this one over here. Now one person still has her trap on, so that's a rough one. There used to be a glitch where you had to literally spam tap the button because they could not take it off. Oh. Yes, please go that direction. I'm not gonna go after him just yet. She's gonna go for the save. Hey, miss me. I think it's the same area where she killed all those pallets. Ah, she got me. Oh wait, this is the same area from before. Hey, nice crouch technique. Really coming in clutch. Oh, someone saved her. I'm just gonna go around slightly. I'm gonna... Got her. That twirl attack is really getting me. Let's get her on the outside. Watch and see if she's smart enough to get away from this. Guess not. Alright, great. Save me some time. Loop her around here and then kick the pallet up top. Yeah, Sky Kirby's really kind of messed up that. No one's down here. It's only one generator left down here at this point. Someone here? Oh. Not gonna go for the save either? Oh, she's almost ticking. I could hear the ticking. She's had that on for a minute. So let's go grab her. See if she can take that off or not. Oh, I can't believe that worked. That was so dumb. Let's see if I can go grab her real fast. Or if that other person will go get her. That was dumb. That's amazingly dumb. Alright, she went around here. That was so amazingly dumb. I am so surprised that worked, but hey, you know, it's always that extra pixel. And that works in my favor. I don't know where this last person's at. She can get Hatch. This was an interesting series of events. Oh, never mind. No, she can't. Now I'm abusing my power. That being said, oh yeah, I can't open the doors. Like, normally I just open the doors and let someone go. Wait, can I open the doors? But it's already endgame collapsed, I can't. Nope. Well, I assume she's on the other side, then hopefully she can get away. That was fun. It's moments like that that I enjoy. I think the door's already open. Yep. Let's see if I can sneakily do it. Oh no, she actually left. Usually people stay the extra minute. I haven't had that map in a while. I always enjoy the aspect of, like, that's one of the few up and down maps I'm perfectly fine with. Because that one is one where I have the most fun because I can hear everything around me up and down the levels, so I have enough time to deal. Oh, Kendra, that's one I hear a lot. Basically, when you hook a survivor, they can see your, they can see your aura. Yeah, I gotta be wary of that one. Well, this one did not help at all. So much for keeping that one around. Alright, let's go one more game and then I'll call it. What's that? Yeah, aim for two. And just keep it rolling. Okay, so yeah, now that that's done, I want to change out. This one, because hex ones are always a 50-50 bet for me when it comes to whether or not I really want to keep them. Excuse me. Nah, Bitter Murmur is not that fun. No Ed is no Ed. Item consumption rate, remember me. Would that have helped? Yeah, do I want to? No. Alright, let's just keep this. I guess that's the only real... Nothing seems worth it. I wish they kept that for healing speed. This was a great one to add to keep them healing for longer, but now that it doesn't, it's like, well, doesn't really mix too well with anything else. That Discord doesn't come handy on that map, though. Yeah, why not? The weird part is, when they added a perk, I wonder how much they take into the fact that it came from that particular killer. That's also something I want to add to that as well. Like, I know, like, upgrading perks are to, like, change things up and keep things balanced. But anytime I see a perk updated, my first thought is, oh, this works well with other killers, not this works well with the killer that it was made for. Well, yeah, it's there. I have no idea what I'm going to call these things on YouTube either. Never really thought about that. Like, YouTube titles are always the most interesting thing, where sometimes you know exactly what you want to grab, other times you don't. Alright, it seems like a flashlight person, so this is going to be annoying. If I could aim for her, that would be great, but... she's playing the character that's Claudette, so she might end up hiding more times than not. Alright, let's see what I can do with this last game. Hopefully it goes by really quick and they just speedrun the gens and save me some time. Cause then I can just focus on killing, knowing that I gotta worry about the generators. Like, yeah, I'm still conflicting over that I want to worry about the generation or not. Like, because sometimes it can slow down the game, other times it's a waste of time. Like, you're not going to get all four. You got to aim for two. But even then, it's like, well, if the game goes by too fast, you can't really get even two people. Or if you spend most of your time chasing, like that last match with that one chick that broke, like, that made me break, like, five different pallets. Ooh, that was a rough one. Like, I think that's what caused, like, three, that's what caused two of them to die, I want to say. I mean, looping back around those areas and them having no pallets. Like, she made that entire underpath, the entire, like, bottom level, a death trap, basically. Whereas the top level was completely clean for most part. Like, most of those pallets came in at the end. So, like, she kind of made that into her own personal death trap. All right, let's sneak from here. These generators are... Oh, wow, that was disturbingly fast. That was fast. Holy crap. I am so sorry for you. Hey, it's the flashlight person. What do you know? That's the fastest I think I've ever tracked anybody. Alright, let's... I want to hit him. Oh. There's the two generators right next to each other, and I can hear them, like, blasting. How many people am I gonna hit? Also, did my game just spaz out? Yeah, it did. Oh no, there was a tree there. Alright, she's in an infinite loop, so not much I could do against... Oh. No, she kind of messed up. This has been an interesting case. I have never found people this fast on this map before. Alright. She's up top. See if I can grab her real fast. The answer is yes. See, people with flashlights are very bold. She's going around. That's the word I want to use, bold. And I'm tired of worrying about this area and I want to go somewhere else, and they're making it very difficult to lay out of this place. I hate these cornfields. It's really impossible to see. Whenever they update this map, I'm really curious what they're going to do. Someone literally run all the way over here. Or is it the Claudette being a Claudette? Well, that's the only direction I have right now, so I gotta work with it. Oh, she's on death's door. Oh. That was a fast jolt there that even I wasn't expecting. Hey, it's Flashlight Chick again. We're really meeting up a lot lately. There we go. I wanted to moon that walk that a little bit more. She's really trying to get in a sticky situation here where I can't grab her. I've seen that happen before. It's quite annoying. Is someone else with a flashlight? No, she was the only one, unless they grab one out of the, She's over here. Last I saw someone. Or I thought she was. Holy crap, that's a lot of generators. Yeah, she got that one off. Well, nothing I can do in that scenario, and they're over here. Got Ayu. Hey, Yamato. Bury the light, man. You have my respect. If you're the last one alive, I'll probably let you go, to be honest. I thought I was in the alternate direction. Alright, let's break this. Someone grab her up. I wasn't gonna actually get her down. Once again, I have the, nope, not gonna worry about that. I have like two more of these. Yeah, let's get her in here. Got her. Alright, you just have to play that for a little bit. Get as many of those generators as they want done now. Next one is going to be over here. I don't know where she's at. Like, I could kick those to change the game up, but I'm like, eh. Just let it ride. Like I said, I feel this is a lot of work just to do so. And I'm running out of places to find these guys. And they're healing. Oh. Hey, how's it going? Okay, this is not going to be fun. I lost track of her. That's unfortunate. That's why I hit the cornfield. It's really difficult for me to keep track of people. Hey, buddy, how's it going? Oh, yeah, one of your friends already used that. Hopefully they pick her up so I can just use that same hook. Are they going to be kind to me and do that? Yep, they're going to save me some time. She might get out of that. Nope. Thank you. The nearest hook is quite a distance. I might get out of here before I could do anything. Yep. I had a feeling something like that might happen. Hey, how's it going? Thank you for your service. What if I could have enough time to kill her? Let's see if this last person's having fun. There we go. Kill her. Keep it moving. She's up. Where are they at, though? Hey! Not the wisest move. Alright, no one in locker. All right, back to the same exact hook as before. You guys are really hitting that spot. I have yet to kick a generator as well, which I find to be quite interesting. Nope, she's going for the heals, so I'm coming right back. Nope, not over it. Where did he just run off to? Oh, he's over there. Talk about losing track of a guy. Alright, these circle techniques are really getting to me. Going over there. How are they failing? Did they make them more difficult? Oh, there she is. Okay, let's kill her to save me some time. There we go. Any of those? Ah, that one's all the way over there. And they're going to the left. Sneak up. Follow the blood trail, follow the blood trail. Oh, that was an odd one. This is gonna be fun. And dead? He tried to make it towards Hatch. Makes sense. This is the same hook they've all been on all day. Well, there goes that one. Didn't kick a single generator either. Well, that is kind of shows the extent sometimes of just not doing gens. You just leave it and it just works on its own sometimes. Got two kills and then that added to three by accident. Anyway, I think that's a good enough place to stop. That being said, I do thank you guys for watching. And if you can, go out and support whatever content creator you can and stay safe out there. Next one, I'm debating if I should do Control or Castlevania. I'll think about it. That being said, stay safe out there.